Hello, everyone. I am Tiffany Starr, and you are talking with Tiff.
If you're a conservative Republican, oh, look at the pretty colors. Oh, look at the pretty colors up the going this way off the channel. All right, now that the people with toddler-like minds are gone, we can get back to grown-up business. So we'll go over this real quick. It's not going to take nearly as long, but I do want to go over it. So, does anyone know what Bernie or Bust is? Basically, Bernie or Bust is, if Bernie doesn't win the primary, then the people who were supporting him who are Bernie or Bust will not vote, or the alternative, which in this case is Biden. And a lot of the advocates for this are actually big left-wing YouTubers. Is Kyle Kulinski. He's got a large subscriber base. 836K. Wow. He's Bernie or Bust. He's gonna vote third party. Unless there's concessions, he won't vote for Biden. He's in New York, so his vote might not really matter that much. But everyone who watches him, they might not know that. Some of the people watching Kyle Kulinski could be in the red states or the purple states, the swing states that we need. This is Shaun. Shaun is also a left tuber. Now keep in mind, I actually like both Kyle Kulinski and Shaun. They make some great content. And they are on my side. They politically align with me. So I'm not, like, attacking them, per se. I'm attacking their position on Bernie or Bust. Shaun has 319K subs. Not a lot, but considering he only puts out a video every 2 to 3 months, it's pretty good. He puts a lot of work into his videos. Thing is, Shaun is in the UK. He's not in America. But he still pushes Bernie or Bust. He doesn't say, don't vote for Biden. Let me be clear. Neither does Shaun. What they say is, you can vote for whoever you want, but I'm not voting for Biden. But what that means is, I'm not voting for Biden, and you shouldn't either. Well, I'm not voting for Biden. Maybe you shouldn't vote for Biden either, but you can vote for whoever you want. That's pretty much Kyle and Shaun's position. So, here's the problem. They're entitled to their opinion, but they don't understand the situation. Kyle is a straight cis white male, and there's nothing wrong with that at all. But he doesn't realize that if Trump gets reelected, he's not going to be affected as much. So he has some privilege there. He's not going to get affected by any anti-gay and lesbian policies because he's not gay. He's not going to get affected by any anti-trans policies because he's not trans. He's not going to get affected by any immigration policies because he's not an immigrant. He's not going to get affected by any racist laws or policies that come into place because he's not black, Mexican, or Asian. Yeah, he won't get knocked about by cops, Jariah is exactly right. If the world went to hell and a fascist dictatorship happened tomorrow, he would be okay. He could just like fit in and be upset that the left lost and fucking hate life, but he wouldn't be murdered. He wouldn't be getting towed to the gas chambers. And Shaun doesn't even live in the fucking country. Now, you don't have to live in America to have an opinion on the American election. But Shaun also has some privilege because he's not going to have to deal with the repercussions. The only thing he might feel the effects of is any trade policies that change between the United States and the UK. These two are saying, you don't have to vote for Biden. I mean, Bernie was your candidate of choice, and Biden offers you nothing, so why vote for him? Even though I hate Biden, I despise Biden, I think Biden is terrible, he's an awful human being, Biden does have something that does appeal to me. And it might not be progressive left-wing policy, but he has the ability to stop things from getting worse. Because what he wants to do is revert back to normal, and normal is shit. But right now, we're in fucking hell. If Trump gets another 4 years, what kind of damage will he do? He's already packing the courts with conservative judges, and if he's president again, he'll make the Supreme Court 2/3 conservative. And if he makes the Supreme Court 2/3 conservative, and they implement another younger guy, because it's a lifetime appointment, then we're going to have a conservative majority until we're all dead. But also, he can start implementing policies that hurt me and people like me, marginalized people. Homeless shelters have the right to refuse trans people. Trump banned trans people from joining the military. So what other issues will he bring about? Keeping the immigration ban permanent so no one comes into the country? That's fascist-like behavior. Deport more people? Even people who are technically US citizens, but They're brown so bad. More kids in cages? Yes, I know Obama did it too, but he didn't separate families. There's gonna be a lot of damage if Trump gets another 4 years. That won't affect Shaun or Kyle Kulinski. So their Bernie or bust position should probably be reevaluated because it makes them look incredibly selfish. I understand how frustrating it is that our choice is between two mentally inept men, both of whom have sexual allegations against them. However, we can't lose focus of the bigger picture. We have to vote strategically, otherwise the left you want will never come to fruition. If Biden gets into office, it'll mitigate damage and give us 4 years to move people over to the left. So bite the bullet and vote Biden. We can't survive the alternative. Thanks for watching and subscribe to be notified when I drop a new video.